So this is a story about how I almost met Dorothy. The band. My ears itchy. The band. It's my band. Okay, anyway. How I almost met Dorothy. By the way, she is so gorgeous. If you don't know who she is, you guys need to look up the band Dorothy. So it was Earth Day birthday in Florida, Orlando, Florida. I was going by myself to this place. And I think it was like the Florida Fairgrounds or something. Because I had no one else to go with, and I was like, whatever. But it was a bunch of different bands, and I was only there to see Dorothy. Yes, there was Hailstorm and Fit for Rivals, but I was mostly there just to see Dorothy. So I was very excited to see that she was indeed there, because I bought the tickets and they said she was there, and then later on they said, oh sorry, Dorothy will not be there. And then the day of, they were like, hey, Dorothy's here. And I'm like, okay, good, because I bought these tickets. And I go in, and New Year's Day. I watched New Year's Day play, and then I met this guy, and he was like, oh yeah, I sell pictures. Like, I need an autograph so I can sell these. And I was like, okay, cool, whatever. I didn't really care, but it was someone to talk to. So after New Year's Day and after talking to him, wandered around, I found the merch thing, and I bought a shirt from them. I bought two shirts from them and a CD. And then, because one was for me, one was for my boyfriend. And so I just walk around, wait for Dorothy to play. You know, there's an alligator there, a baby alligator, so people can touch it. And so Dorothy is going on. I'm there early. I'm literally one person away from touching the barricades. I'm very happy. I'm almost center. I'm like, this is gonna be amazing. I don't, like, this is a, whatever they're called. Called when it's a bunch of bands playing. Anyway, you know what I'm talking about, but it was that. And a festival. It was a music festival. And that's a great place to meet a band that you love, because most likely they're gonna be walking around doing other things there. And Dorothy had this set and then an acoustic set later on. So I was like, oh my god, I get to see Dorothy two times. And they're probably, like, they have to walk to these buildings, so I'm, like, definitely gonna be able to walk into them. Like, I'm gonna completely stalk them. Because, yes, I am very calm, and I'm not very, like, I don't know. But I do like to, like, kind of wait around and stalk people. Not in a bad way, but, it starts, and I'm like, oh my god, she's even prettier in person, and, like, her voice is so amazing. And it was so good. But then the girl I'm standing in front of was probably like 15, I was like 17. And her dad is like, this guy's standing way too close to my daughter, he needs to back up. And he's like swearing to like his friend or someone else that was like his age. And he was like, no, he doesn't, he's fine. He is not that close to her. And literally I took a picture, I was like this far away from her. Like, probably like this actually, because I was very afraid of that man because he kept looking at me and glaring at me and saying very loud, rude things about how he was gonna punch me and stuff. And I was like, what? If you don't like it, move your daughter to the other side, dude. Like, I'm standing far apart. Also, I'm very gay. Clearly, I was very gay. Like, sorry about it. And I wasn't even looking at her. I wasn't even doing anything. I was too busy looking at Dorothy on the stage. Beautiful, beautiful Dorothy. So the set's over. I leave as fast as I can because I don't need to stay around that man. And I don't think I saw any of them. Or I did. And they were going to the back where all the fans were, or buses were. Maybe I didn't see them. But I went back there. Not to the buses because you couldn't, because there was a gate. But I just waited there. And I missed them. I missed Dorothy anyway. She was already on her bus. And then two of the guys from the band who aren't in the band anymore, apparently there's some drama, so I don't know who the bad one was out of the band, but I met two of them. I'll have the pictures up there now. So I met them. They were very nice. Yet again, it was a situation I didn't ask for a picture. I was just talking about it. I didn't talk about Dorothy. That's her real name, I think. I didn't talk about her at all. I was just like, you guys were amazing. I love you guys so much. Like, I just found you guys on YouTube, and I've been obsessed with you guys, and I'm just talking about them. And I was like, it was just so amazing to see you guys. I was just talking about how I didn't think they were gonna be there, but then they were. I was so excited, and I got their merch. And they're like, oh, do you want a picture? And it's like, yeah, I want a picture. So they got someone to take a picture. And they were like, well, it was really nice meeting you. I don't even know. We probably talked for a while. And I was like, oh, yeah, it was really nice meeting you guys. And then they left. So then, I think Fifth Arrivals already went, so I already saw them. And then they came out and I met them. She was very like, whatever. Which is very weird to me because they were not popular. Like, they're not popular at all. And so I went to them and I was like, I love you guys. I loved you guys since like your first album. Like, I was obsessed with you guys. She was like, oh, thanks. And that was pretty much that. She did not care at all. She's like, she just kept walking. And I was like, that's the first band I've ever met that's been like that. I've met other bands I didn't really like. I've met bands who were like popular-ish and they were very nice. I've met drag queens, like popular ones, like who won RuPaul's Drag Race, and they were very nice. I'm like, so I don't understand how someone who's not popular is very rude. I've met other bands who had like 100 followers on Instagram, well, like 1,000, and they were very nice too. Like, they gave me free stuff. Not that I needed free stuff, but they did. And I was like, oh my god, like, you guys are amazing. But anyway, I talk a lot. So I wait around probably like 2 hours in the sun. It was summertime, or it was Earth Day, I don't know when that is. But it was very hot because it's Florida. It's summertime. I mean, it's sunny. And so it's almost time for the acoustic set. I go over there. I don't remember exactly when these events happened, so sorry if they had the acoustic set after, I don't remember. So I go over there, I get a pretty good seat, you know, like, I'm close, but not too close. I have a video on my other channel, I'll link you guys to that video, or I won't, actually. But, yeah. It has like 5,000 views or something. I'm like, oh my god, why? But, so there's that video. I mean, I saw them, and then they were like, okay, Dorothy's doing a meet and greet. And I was like, yes, queen. Like, I'm gonna tell her I do, like, drag, like, inspired by her, and I'm so excited. And then that guy from earlier comes up and goes, hey, can you watch my stuff? And I'm not the person to be like, uh-uh. I'm just like, yeah, sure, okay. He's like, I won't be too long. So he goes up, comes back. I'm freaking out because I'm like, oh my god, like, they're not gonna be out much longer. Like, he took forever. And so I go up, I'm waiting in line. I'm waiting. It's been like 10 minutes since I've been waiting in line. I'm the next person to meet Dorothy. Hallelujah. And then their manager, whoever, goes, okay, from here, no one else is gonna meet them. I'm gone, by the way. Like, I am so upset and mad. I think I was mostly mad. Not at Dorothy, not at anyone else, but at that man. So, so they were done, and so Dorothy left, and I walked over to meet the other part of the band, but then they were being dragged away, and I was like, okay, whatever. That must have been before I actually met them. So, oh yeah, it was before I actually met them. I think I went right over to the acoustic stage. So then I go out of the acoustic place to, like, find Dorothy. I'm, like, determined to meet her. I'm like, oh my god. So I go out. As I go out, there's a golf cart driving up. Goes past me. Guess who's in the passenger seat? Dorothy. The singer of Dorothy, the most beautiful woman on earth. And she sees me and she goes, and I was like, I think I waved back. I was probably like, I was freaking out. I was like, oh my god, like, she saw me, she waved, she knows I exist. She made eye contact with me while she was singing too, not the acoustic stage, and that killed me too. So I didn't get to meet her. I met the other part of the band. I just stood there forever, got a snow cone, got water, went to the bathroom, never got to meet Dorothy. My phone was at 9%. I texted my mom to come get me because my phone was going to die and I wasn't going to be able to leave. And it was like 5 more hours until the thing was done, or 4 more hours, and I was like, this is too long. Like, I haven't really seen anyone except Hailstorm, but like, whatever, I'm not gonna die. So then I leave, and that's pretty much how the story of how I almost met Dorothy. Make sure you stay tuned for the next video on how I met Palariel. Make sure you watch my past video on how I almost met Kesha. Wow, riveting. If you guys liked this video, make sure to like and subscribe and share it with your friends, family, and other people. And if you didn't like it, make sure to share it with your enemies so they can watch this crappy video too. Thank you.